The Scheme Villains Self-Saving System, Chapter 13, Audio Source, WooshaWorldAudiobook.com. Chapter 13. Tien finally found a good, cultivating reference for translation. Jinden Golden Core, Pellet, Dan Core Formation. Lol. Ling Mai, Spirit Veins. Also, the spirit cave that Lu Qingge was in is called Ling Shi Cave. His hammer had already been taken away by Shen Qingchu, but couldn't he use his body to crush Luo Binger to death? Seeing him open his arms as though to embrace Luo Binger, it was as though lightning had struck in Shen Qingchu's mind and cleared a few bends in thought. He broke out in cold sweat. Fuck me, fuck me, fuck me, fuck me, fuck me, fuck me. He was still wearing the poison-spiked armor. At this moment, Shen Qingchu completely forgot about Luo Binger's golden body and the rule of the undying protagonist. Putting himself in peril, he unconsciously chose to move over and block again. The Xuya sword exited its scabbard and the snow-white sword light pierced Elder Tian Chui and gave him a critical injury. But Tian Chui relied on his brute force and viciousness to move forward, unwilling to retreat even if a hole was bored through him. Instead, he was overjoyed and charged forward, letting the Xuya sword pierce out through his back. A grim smile stretched across his face as he changed his direction towards Shen Qingchu. Shen Qingchu promptly made the decision and let go, but it was already too late. His right hand felt the pain of getting pierced. Suddenly, he felt a wave of cold from his heart to the bottom of his feet. Tian Chui collapsed on the ground and spit out a mouthful of blood. He laughed crazily. Shen Qingchu was made by me into funerary goods, ha. Worth it. Shizun. Luo Binger suddenly caught Shen Qingchu's right hand. His eyes were red. Shizun, you were pierced by the spike. Shen Qingchu opened his hand and said, it's nothing. I didn't get pierced. Don't listen to him exaggerate just to alarm people. Quote, as he spoke, he glanced down. In his mind and heart there was a string of scrolling fuck 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 brushed all over the screen. From the back of his hand to his arm, there were rows of small pinholes. They were already starting to turn red. Good thing that he didn't have an intense phobia. Rather, it was Luo Binger whose face turned completely white after seeing it. Who could hear the raging waves and stormy seas in Shen Qingchu's heart? Damn, how many times have I been dropped into a pit by the protagonist? It's already been said he won't die, he won't die. You specially went up and hurried to rescue his life for what? A fuck, fuck, fuck. Elder Tian Chui had finally dragged someone with him to be his funeral bed, and it was even a funeral bed of decent weight. He wasn't depressed anymore and happily said, this old man never says things just to alarm people. If I say this poison has no cure, then there is no cure. Peak Lord Shen, peacefully wait for death. Sword light flashed. Luo Binger drew the Xuya sword and held it against Yan Chui's neck, his movement so quick and smooth that Shen Qingchu almost didn't see it. It was as though Luo Binger had become another person. Angrily, he said, impossible. There must be a way, only you're unwilling to give out the cure. Sha Huling suddenly said, Tian Chui truly didn't lie to this young gentleman. This poison is called without a cure. One towards humans, it truly is without cure. He is already going to die, how can he be afraid of you using his death to bargain with him? Without a cure. In this life, he hasn't heard of a poison whose name was given as little thought as this one. Although he read the original work and already knew there was such a strong poison, there was still no way to stop Shen Qingchu from cursing Great God Airplane towards the sky's pragmatism and choosing names. Light flashed in Sha Huling's gaze. She saw that the circumstances had obviously changed and was considering the good idea of making a comeback. But how could Shen Qingchu be unclear about her pissy character? He cycled spiritual power and ceaselessly suppressed the needle-like pain and vacuum-like feeling in his right hand at the same time. Wearing a small smile on his lips, he pretended to be relaxed and said, "Saying words like these isn't bad. But Miss Sha, have you forgotten how many years I have? Does middle stage core formation still count as mortal?" Sha Huling's expression changed, but then she quickly calmed down and laughed. "Whether or not you're mortal, I don't know. However, I know a way to prove whether Elder Shen is really poisoned. If someone has been affected by, without a cure, starting from the wound, their spiritual power circulation will be interrupted. Slowly it will spread to the entire body. Finally, not only spiritual power but even blood will stagnate and cause the person to die. I invite Elder Shen to use his right hand to try a strong spiritual power attack. You will be able to see the outcome. A strong spiritual power attack, as the name suggests, is to take a great amount of spiritual power and circulate it to a certain point and then letting it suddenly explode. It uses the violent shock of the spiritual power's explosion to produce an attacking effect. The result is similar to flipping down a switch and launching a missile or throwing out a detonator. The strength is determined by the person's cultivation. Shen Qingchu privately tried before and was able to reach the level of throwing out a grenade. But now, his right hand was just like an intricate robot that had part of an electrical circuit removed. He used all his effort and strength, but the circulation of spiritual power was completely blocked. "Damn, this old man shouldn't be wasted just like this, right?" Luo Binger heard the description of without a cure, and his lips trembled. At this moment, he forgot Shen Qingchu's bad treatment of him in the past. It was completely erased from his heart. He was only very clear that Shizune's cultivation had been harmed by the demons to the point that his cultivation might be wasted, to the extent that he might be killed. And all of this was all for him. Shen Qingchu saw his expression change and readily touched his head. "No need to worry." Raising his eyes, Shen Qingchu laughed eccentrically. "It won't hurt to give it a try. But this matter can't be tried without anything in return. Miss Sha, you entered and created chaos in Qiongding Peak, and this Shen always kept his forbearance. Now I've changed my mind. You can't just come and go as you please. How can I let my Kangqiong Mountain sect be laughed at by others? Why don't we compare a few attacks and make it a life and death match? If there are any injuries, we have only ourselves to blame. Whatever happens next, no one will pursue. How is it? He cannot show weakness now. Everyone on the entire Qiongding Peak relied on him as the sole elder present to prop them up. Once he fell down, according to Sha Huling's calculations, the clear result would be the demons lighting fire and burning down all of Qiongding Peak. Watching the sect sign be carried away by them back to the demon realm, and the sect's prestige dropping sharply thereafter. If serious, the entire mountain would be massacred. Don't doubt. This woman definitely dared to do this kind of thing. Better to make a bet quickly and gamble. Shen Qingchu didn't notice that unknowingly, he already didn't consider any of these anxious, steadfast, indignant, or guarding disciples as the mob characters talked about in the novel. Sha Huling bit her lips and felt tangled. If Shen Qingchu really had an extraordinary human body, that poison would have no effect on him. Were the two of them to fight, judging by pure strength of their spiritual power, she would die without knowing it. But if he was only standing weakly and immediately dying afterwards or making an empty show of strength, after this trial there would be the great opportunity of Qiongding Peak. Wouldn't she regret it for life? Shen Qingchu calmly looked at her and waited for her decision as though he wasn't expecting an answer. Luo Binger pulled at his sleeve and said in a low voice, Shizune, this disciple is willing to receive the attack in your stead. Shen Qingchu's expression didn't change as he pulled back his sleeve and said, since when is there the reasoning that a disciple should stand in the stead of the Shifu? Luo Binger said, Shizune was injured because of this disciple. Shen Qingchu glared at him. Since you know this injury is because of you, you should properly protect your own life. Luo Binger's mouth opened but he couldn't speak. His eyes became even more red. In the end, Sha Huling gritted her teeth. Then Elder Shen, please forgive Ling Er for being rude. Shen Qingchu said, I won't be merciful. Sha Huling's heart beat rapidly and didn't even dare to speak back. A shadow of red flame rose with her snow-white hand, accompanied by an overbearing demonic energy. WuxiaWorldAudio.com. She attacked. With one foot, Shen Qingchu kicked Luo Binger clear. Preparation done, he was willing to use his fleshly body to meet this palm. However, he had neither been sent flying by this strike of Sha Huling's nor had vomited a burst of blood and died. Full of killing aura, once his sword exited the scabbard he saw Baizan Peak's law dissolve Sha Huling's attack without moving a finger. He simply used the force of a burst of spiritual power emanating from his body. After a moment of silence, Qiongding Peak seemed to fly up to the sky. Martial Uncle Lu. Martial Uncle Lu exited seclusion. Baizan Peak's war god has exited seclusion. See if you demons dare to be arrogant anymore. Shen Qingchu said in his heart, what kind of rubbish is this playing cool? Would you die if you came out earlier? I damn well thought I was going to have to report back to my original world. This was indeed a blameworthy stupid author's stallion novel. After Sha Huling's attack was mitigated, in addition to a soft scream, the red veils that originally covered her body broke into pieces. It caused a spate of exclamations. She used a beautiful posture to tumble and buffer the attack, rolling up with a palm to the ground. As expected, demons really had a bold and unrestrained demeanor. Almost her entire body was a mosaic too, but she still wasn't shy and only viciously pulled over a subordinate's cloak. She carelessly said, everyone, today was my miscalculation. There will be time for goodbyes in the future. Let's go. Lu Qingge laughed coldly. Coming and going as you please. What big face you have. What's the opposite of beauty and thought? Once he reached back and the Cheng Luan sword 3 behind his back flew into the sky, hundreds upon hundreds of bright tangible sword energies arrayed in the sky. They rained down like hail and pierced down on the demons. Sha Huling had to lead and take care of her subordinates as she ran while at the same time making the red veil in her hand into a piece of red cloud and launching it into the sky. However, it completely couldn't block the spiritual swords and quickly the red veil was pierced full of holes all over. Additionally, Kankyong Mountain Sect's disciples blocked their way and a good half of the demons died, were injured, or taken prisoner. They could only closely follow Sha Huling's faithful subordinates killing a bloody path to escape down the mountain. Lu Qingge returned his sword to its scabbard, scowling as he turned around and searched Shen Qingchu's hand for the wound with his gaze. King Jing Peak disciples also surrounded him. Tens of faces were all pale and tense. Shen Qingchu grinned. It looks like making the decision to send someone to imitate Aunt Snow 4 to slap the wall of Lingxi Cave and howl for you to come out was an extremely correct decision. Lu Qingge, who's Aunt Snow? Shen Qingchu, not who. How am I? Lu Qingge snorted. You won't die for now. Though he'd carelessly said those words, his left hand sent spiritual power into Shen Qingchu's body without ceasing and his expression turned serious. He specially clarified, what I owe you back in the spirit caves, I'll return to you. Die proudly. Shen Qingchu felt that his plan to pull Lu Qingge to his side seemed very promising and was very satisfied. but the spirit veins all over his body seemed to spasm and twitch from time to time and made him unable to smile. Luo Binger suddenly said, "Marshal Uncle Lu, this strong poison, without a cure, is it truly without a cure?" Lu Qingge glanced at him and hadn't yet replied when Shen Qingchu's knees suddenly softened and he kneeled down. Fortunately, Luo Binger was always supporting him. However, Shen Qingchu really couldn't stand any longer. He gestured with his hand and said, "Let me lie down. Let me lie down for a while." Luo Binger had never seen a Shen Qingchu appear so weak. His eyes red, he knelt at Shen Qingchu's side and couldn't speak. He could only choke back his misery and call out, "Shizune." Shen Qingchu raised an arm with great difficulty and rubbed his head. The mouthful of blood that he had suppressed for an entire day had finally come out as he quivered, but he persisted in finishing the key words to promote good feelings. "I knew you would definitely win." Hearing these words, Luo Binger's entire body startled. Shen Qingchu expressed his understanding. Luo Binger must have decided that this person was a mental case plus schizophrenic. Truly, if taken from heaven's point of view, Shen Qingchu himself wouldn't be able to tolerate and would throw down the book and curse. This is what kind of TM5 role, one moment fighting and one moment saving. "Are you sick?" At this time, the system delivered its notices. Complexity of the role of Shen Qingchu, +20, literary and philosophical depth, +20, choosing to fight a trial, +10, total gained B points, +50. Shen Qingchu was horrified. The role's philosophical depth could be calculated like this. Plus, don't carelessly open such a strange value, thank you. The view in his two eyes darkening, Shen Qingchu raised his head and thought that he might have seen Luo Binger's tears well up in his eyes and fall down. It had to have been a mistake. This was his last thought before he lost consciousness. End chapter 13. 1. Without a cure, no point leaving it untranslated. 100% literal translation is more like no solution. Pinyin as Wu Qiji. 2. Body a mosaic, basically saying that her body is censored. XD. 3. Cheng Luan sword, multiplying Luan, sword. Luan, is a kind of mythical bird related to the phoenix. 4. Aunt Snow, the nickname of Chinese actress Wang Lin. She got the name after starring in the 2001 movie Romance in the Rain. Neither Luan nor I have watched the movie, but I think you can assume that this Aunt Snow had a scene involving hands slapping the door and a lot of howling. 5 TM, it's short for Tamada or damn fuck. RMC is cursing it as what kind of damn fucking role? End chapter.